This is a further demonstration of the Palm Pre port I was doing for Cheap Gas. And what I have here is a small list from Gas Buddy on prices. Currently, I don't have any sorting capability. I don't really have any search in yet. I just basically have the list. A little disappointed in the dynamic list features of the SDK as it stands now. Not terribly exciting. I can click on a station and have it do a map, and using Google Maps get directions. The nice thing about it is you don't have to close the app down. You can go back and page through on the pre. So there are some advantages to the platform. Honestly, the SDK leaves a lot to be desired in the tools that it gives you to do things like screen design. It's pretty much hand coding where you want things to appear on the screen, which, since it's HTML and CSS, it's no big shakes, but compared to Interface Builder on the iPhone, it's a lot more primitive. Also, the sample code is very skimpy, to say the least. In the entire SDK, there is one example. Or one sample app that does a dynamic list. So pretty poor. The things that I thought would be pretty hard about the port, namely calling GasBuddy to get prices, was actually one of the simpler tasks that I did. It took me about 10 minutes to get that working. The dynamic list I still don't have quite working right, and that's why I'm looking at this static list right here. So I'm going to keep slugging away at it. I may walk away for about a half day just to kind of clear my head as I try to digest everything I've looked at the last day and a half. There are some things that look really slick. Some things are a lot easier, and you definitely don't pull your hair out over memory leak issues with this SDK that you do with say, Objective-C. But in order for you to be productive, you really have to get in, totally immerse yourself into the Mojo widgets and to the Palm way of thinking before you can really kind of get up and productive. So from a standing start, it took me about 2 hours, I would say, before I was able to get some satisfactory stuff out of the SDK. Installing Eclipse, getting the web OS plugins, making sure I had everything set up right on my machine. It's not to say you don't run into the same types of issues when you set the iPhone app as well, getting your provisioning profiles and certificates. It's just that you have a different set of pain with the Palm and the polish is definitely lacking with the SDK. Small things like when you run an app from Eclipse, if the emulator isn't running, it doesn't start up the emulator automatically. So, you know, that's a small thing, but when you do it, you know, a few tens of times during the course of a day, it starts to wear on you. So, some real fit and finish polish things they can do a lot better. And perhaps later versions of the SDK, they'll automate a lot of these low-level tasks so that developers don't have to come totally up to speed to get productive. Hope to be able to report more in the very near future.